artificial intelligence has already weaved its way into our daily lives, whether it be browsing a social media feed or finding your way around town. Other innovations just around the corner are poised to take us into the realm of science fiction. I've just arrived at an event called AI Everything here in Dubai in a driverless car to find out more. I began by meeting with the world's first Minister for Artificial Intelligence.
It's the biggest AI event in the region. We have over 20,000 people coming to this event. And it's a place where everyone can come and at least talk about what the future of this technology should be and what it shouldn't.
What do you think is most important when governing AI?
Creating that level of understanding, increasing AI literacy within government officials is paramount if you're going to be part of the cities or countries that lead this revolution. I think certain sectors are going to benefit a lot from AI. Healthcare, for example, diagnosis. Being able to diagnose any disease with a very high level of efficiency is extremely important. Doctors are going to take patients through the journey of healing, which is what humans are meant to do. It's the social bond.
Again and again, the experts were convinced that healthcare is on the cusp of an AI revolution.
I would have to say healthcare, because it could be so dramatic in terms of healthcare. I mean, here in Dubai, there was an amazing exhibition back in the World Government Summit, which explained, in a sense, the sorts of changes that AI could make and new technologies could make to human longevity between now and 2090. And, you know, in a small way, just the ability to diagnose and prescribe and all that side of things for AI is really powerful, actually.
We have one customer in a city, hospital in the city, with high incidences of tuberculosis. That they wanted to x-ray a huge portion of the city's population. So what we did, we trained the neural network to recognize x-ray images that have TB and no TB. To the extent that now, when a person goes in for an x-ray, the machine immediately, within 1 second, says you are okay. You still have to wait the 2 weeks for the doctor to certify that you're okay. And so far, the machine has not been wrong relative to the doctors.
But what about fears that AI will eliminate jobs?
Well, of course, there is this existential worry about the scale of job loss in the face of AI. Whether it's going to be 25% or 70%, we need to make people absolutely confident about the ability to reskill and that the resources from government are going to be there to help them reinvent themselves throughout the course of their life. And I don't think they're always going to be substituted. I think AI is augmentative, i.e. it helps you do your job, and it isn't just going to simply take it away.
There is one position that talks about humans versus machines. That's an inaccurate view. The way we should be viewing it is, we as humans have unique capabilities. We have a gift around creativity, imagination, emotion. These are capabilities that machines will never have. The question is, how do you take those unique gifts of a human being and then partner that with the power of AI to be able to deliver benefits to society?
Without huge amounts of data, there can be no AI. But with scandals constantly hitting the headlines about the misuse, hacking and leaking of personal data, how can we ensure our privacy is safe? And what ethical frameworks should guide this technology's development?
If indeed we as humanity, I mean we with a capital W, are to be able to realize the real benefits of AI, we have to do so in an open and collaborative fashion to ensure that we have common data standards, common privacy standards, and a common set of metrics for what good looks like.
Well, the absolute key priority for me is to try and get some ethical framework agreed. Now, that could be domestically, but more importantly, it needs to be internationally. And I'm really intent on the Osaka G20 meeting actually having more than just data governance on the agenda, that if they can get into the AI ethical framework area, then I really think that would be a huge benefit internationally, because it would be a level playing field for the development of AI.
My proposition is that for the ethics part, first we understand the differences between how a human thinks or makes decision and how a machine makes decision. While the machine will, as it gets more intelligent, will be making more and more the correct decisions for us, yeah? But we humans still need to be there to make sure that it is also the right decision, because what's correct may not always be right, yeah?